Now here's your host of This Is, John and Bill.
Well, Bill, it looks like we made it to another amazing amusement park.
You know what, John? We're here at Darien Lake today, and I'm so happy to be here. I've been wanting to come to this park for a long time, haven't you?
That's correct, Bill. And for everyone out there, to give you some sort of idea of where this park came from, this was originally one of the Funtime amusement parks before Premier bought it and then bought Six Flags and turned this into a Six Flags park. This park has had many problems in the past, but we're here to see how this this gem of a park has evolved into one of the greatest amusement parks in America.
Well, that's correct. Right now it's being managed by the Hershender family, and they also manage Dollywood and the new Illich Gardens as well.
Yes, they also own the Silver Dollar City as well. So without further ado, this is Darien Lake.
Here we are at Darien Lake, Bill.
Yeah, we're inside the park now, and what we're looking at is the entryway plaza.
Yeah, they have a very nice little entryway plaza here. They also have a fountain that's a little bit farther on down, which we'll see here in a moment.
Yeah, and around that fountain area is where they do a daily show when they open the park.
That's right.
If you happen to be at Darien Lake when it opens, please do catch the show. It's quite a little presentation that they do.
That's correct. And also, you want to make sure that if you get a chance to go to the water park, you see one of the slides back there in the backside. The unique thing about that is they're all tube slides, no body slides.
Yeah, that's correct. And they have some very interesting tube slides to boot. The water park is split into two sections. And what you do is cross over a bridge to get between the two sections.
That's right. Here we are on the Ride of Steel. This is a very unique coaster. It was, I think, one of the first Enemann hyper coasters. And because of that, there are some flaws, as we all know in the industry, with this coaster. Sort of.
Well, it does have two rather long, drawn-out helix sections to the ride, and you don't really get a lot of G-forces laterally off of them. You can basically just sit up in your seat and not have to worry much.
But it's the bunny hills on the way back that are really abrupt. There's one that's almost like on a turn, and that's usually where the problems are. And all you have to do is Google, you'll find what we're talking about. We aren't going to discuss it here.
No, there's really no need to discuss that. But overall, it's a really wonderful coaster. If you like airtime, you'll definitely enjoy this. Those little bunny hills are definitely quite interesting.
Okay, I think we have someone here that's going to talk about the coaster here in a little bit. So sit back and enjoy the view.
So, Bill, you just got off of the Ride of Steel. How was it?
Well, I'll tell you what. For a coaster that's a little over 200 feet tall, it packs a lot of punch. You know, you have a lot of turnarounds that have a very large amount of positive G-forces pushing you down in your seat. You've also got some bunny hills, and even just the second hill, after you go down the lift hill and then onto the second hill, you get a lot of nice negative G-forces.
Would you consider this in the same class as Magnum at Cedar Point?
It's close, but not quite to Magnum standard. But I'll tell you what, if you get a chance to come out to this park, do ride this coaster, you won't be disappointed.
Thank you, Bill, and this is Darien Lake.
Thank you.
you just survived the clutches of the Predator. How was Darien Lake's only wooden coaster?
It was great. It's a little bit rough right now. It needs some retracking on it. And it has a lot of potential to be a really great ride. Right now, it's why we call Summer's Den rough. Yeah, compared to other Summer's Den rides, it was a very good ride. It had some interesting elements for Summer's Den. I don't know if that was maybe because this was built towards the end of his coaster designing career. Maybe this had some of his daughter's influence in it, which really made it some interesting popping elements. But yeah, it needs a little bit of work, but it has a great potential, and we invite you to come out here to Darien Lake and ride this ride, and this is Darien Lake. The Moto Coaster at Darien Lake. This is a very unique ride. It was built by Zamprilla. It is the official motorcycle themed roller coaster. Very quick turning, very nice acceleration off the line. You get to about, I believe it's about 20 miles an hour. And awesome ride. If you get out here, come ride it. Unique experience you won't find anywhere else. Remember, this is Darien Lake.
Here we are at the Beaver Brothers Lakeside Cafe.
Yes, we visited the Beaver Brothers Lakeside Cafe while we were at Darien Lake, and it's probably one of the best eateries in the park.
That's right. The neat thing is, because of all the hardwood and everything, they have beavers stuck all over this place. Hey, try to see how many you can find when you come there.
Yeah, great food selection, very friendly service. I would highly recommend this when you're in the park.
That's right. And maybe after you get done, maybe a little something sweet for you. This is probably the only amusement park that I know of that has a full-time pastry shop inside the park. That's saying something. There's some that deal with sweets that don't even have that.
That's correct. And look at all these wonderful treats that you can pick up at Darien Lake.
Now, here's something. This is a real throwback. Fascination. I think there's only two of these left in the entire United States. It's a game where you take little rubber balls, try to make tic-tac-toe, basically.
Well, and here we're going to give you an example. I actually sat down and played this game, and it is quite entertaining. You just basically roll the balls and try to make like a line across or diagonally, this or that. and win some tickets for some great prizes.
That's right. The thing about this this particular attraction is people would come in here and they would just sit here all day long sometimes, and they'd get their little tickets, and at the end of the year they would be flocking to one of these places to cash in their tickets for prizes. And we're not talking just little prizes either. There was like big screen TVs. There were even sometimes cars available at some of these locations. Not this one, but some of the others there was.
Hey, John, I think I won that round.
Yes, you did.
Hey, Bill.
Yes?
We were just on the boomerang.
Yeah, we were.
What do you think of it?
Well, you know, it's your typical boomerang. It's a rubber stamp ride, but I'll tell you what, these are great little rides. Good to go on there, get a little bit of dizziness, come off, you know. Good overall ride. And we're here at Darien Lake. This is Darien Lake. Aerodynamics design coaster. What did you think of it today, Charles?
Great ride. Top speed of 50 miles per hour. It has 5 inversions. I think it's the first one that had 5. It has standard aero jerkiness, but you expect that with an aero design. And what the best thing about this ride is, even a wide guy like me can fit on it.
That's right, aerodynamics design all their coasters so that 95% of the average population can ride that coaster. So what you need to do is come out here to Darien Lake, ride the Viper, get a great ride, and remember, this is Darien Lake.
like, and we just got off of a great roller coaster, and what was the name of that coaster, Charles?
Mind Eraser, I think.
Mind Eraser. Yeah, that's it. At Classic Vekoma SLC, a lot of great elements in it. Put you upside down a couple of times. What did you think of it today, Charles?
Great overall fun ride. However, it is a standard Vekoma cookie cutter fare, but as I said, overall it's just a fun ride.
That's right, and you can ride that right here at Darien Lake. And remember, this is Darien Lake.
And here we are. We're walking the Games Midway section here.
That's right. There's a lot of unique little games in this area, and it's really worthwhile for you to go around in this area and try some of the games out.
Yeah, the games here, you can win things such as a fluffy horse or unicorn. I'm not sure which one that is. But very fun for children. There's a whack-a-mole game, things like that. So,
yeah. The standard amusement park games. Here we have a couple of whirligig rides. I don't really know what this one is. It's been a while since I've seen this one. But it's available. They're fun. And we'll see what else we can do here. The park is pretty unique because it has gone through so many hands that it's just amazing that it's still around in some respects. Here's the Silver Bullet.
Yeah, I believe this is your typical Enterprise ride. Fun for some people. It takes you, around and upside down at the same time. But this one's a very nice version of it.
Now here we are on another one of our midways, or Darien Lake's midways, and we have the rock climb.
Yeah, we saw several people attempting this throughout the day, and it gets you up in the air a little bit. Now here we have a couple little shops.
Yes, and it's always a good place to go and find something unique to buy here in the park. I have to mention the seagulls were pretty good that day too.
The seagulls at Darien Lake are nothing to sneeze at.
That's for certain. Here we have the pirate ship, or pirate ride.
Pirate ride, a great one for a little bit of air time, out of your seat, negative G-force. Standard fare.
That's right. The day here was a little bit overcast, so it did drive away a few of the people, but it still had a pretty good crowd there that day. They also have paddle boats. You don't see too many parks with paddle boats anymore.
And here we have the dodgems, or bumper cars, as they call them here. A lot of people like to ride these. These happen to zoom around pretty quickly on this track.
Again, it's one of those circular tracks, not a chaos track. Some people like the chaos tracks a little bit better. There's no rhyme or reason, just the ability for people to get their anger out on their fellow drivers, which is ironically what this was designed for originally.
We have a lot of people here. Yep, there we are. We have a couple of more.
Looks like a need for a chiropractor.
And the little headlights are blinking on and off because it is drawing electrical power from the roof.
All right, folks. There are top spin brides out there that are insane. There are top spin brides out there that people have broken world records on the number of flips. I think this is the one that first time I've ever seen a top spin ride that has done zero flips. And gave you a long ride, too.
And we do mean zero flips. There's a great theming to this ride, but they don't give you any swinging flips.
Now this
here you're going to see a locked-in flip, but it doesn't swing flip.
Yeah, and then they're going to let you go here, and... That's right, you didn't flip. You're not going to flip. They're going to keep on telling you. You want to ride some more? And people say, yeah, we want to ride more. You still aren't getting a flip.
I think a rocking chair might be more fun than this.
Yeah. Great ride, theme ride and everything, but no flips. Not really high on my level.
And you'll notice there's not very many people on this ride at this point either.
That's right. It's not like we're trying to lambaste this ride or anything, but folks, get either a better program or a better operator. My gosh. Zero flips on a ride that's supposed to flip ya? Come on.
And they just let you hang and move back and forth.
Here's part two, sort of similar to the first part, just no even a lock in on it.
And the worst part of the whole deal, they keep asking you if you want more.
And people keep on saying, yes, yes, maybe I'll actually get something fun out of this. Yes, give me more, please. Someone must have gotten into the juju juice again.
Yeah, it looks like we're building to a flip here. And no.
Okay, let's return you back to your starting positions now. And do you want to ride some more?
Really? Do we have to?
Yes. Yes, you do. Here, you can go again for the final spin.
After all, you did pay to ride this.
You mean you have to pay to ride this?
Well, it's part of the admission.
Oh, yeah.
But like I said, you could have maybe...
Look, it's a locked-in flip!
Oh, my.
Oh, wow.
Wow. There's again.
Another one! Wow. Not quite.
No. Because, you see, we can't actually flip the gondola.
Like I said, great theming, but... Lord.
I think this needs some work.
It needs something, all right.
Yet again, no flip. And that's it.
This is just a beautiful shot. I put it in there because it was, heck, it was a beautiful shot. The Ferris wheel mirrored in the lake, it just has a classic look to it that you just don't see anymore.
And don't forget, when you are done with the day, sometimes Darien Lake at night will have a wonderful laser light show.
Oh, yes they will. Man, that show is probably one of the best I've ever seen. Here we have a UFO. And, well, basically it's a stainless steel rodeo.
A rodeo themed to space.
Yes. After all, it is the final frontier.
Just don't wear your red shirt on the ride.
Lord help you. Here we are, folks. Ranger. This is our last ride of the day. It's one of those banana boat spaceship things that flip you upside down.
Yep, those are very common at county fairs all over the country.
That's right. And we'd like to thank the staff here for allowing us to take and do all this crazy stuff inside the park. We'd also like to remind you that don't forget to go and see the laser light show at the end of the day.
Yeah, they have a wonderful laser light show. And this is not one of these cheesy, cheap laser light shows either.
That's right. They have a lot of neat special effects, fireworks, and I think it's going to get better here in the future.
Yeah, they have in the past, and they are in the future, they have some musicians and bands that come in and do concerts in the venue they have the laser light show at.
That's right. And if you would like to have a close place to stay and you're not afraid of camping, or maybe take the RV with you, well, the Darien Lake State Park is right around the corner. We mean literally right around the corner.
Yeah, I believe it's less than about 1.2 miles or something like that.
Better on that vicinity.
They have clean restrooms, clean showers. We actually stayed there when we were doing this video, and we would highly recommend it.
That's right. They have everything from open field to wooded lots available. So give it a shot. It's moderately priced, and it's a state park, so it can't be influenced to jack that price up because you happen to be right next to an amusement park.
That's right. And while you're in the area, check out the area. There's neat things to do right around the Buffalo vicinity.
That's right. And so, I'm John.
And I'm Bill.
And this is Darien Lake.
The proceeding has been a Castle Guard production. This presentation is under a Creative Commons License 3.0 Attribution, Non-Commercial, Share Alike.